You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Monday, the 2nd of August, 2021, 18th week in ordinary time. Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Nchimunya Christabel Mainza, celebrating her birthday today, a Daily Bread member from Hova, Sweden.
I am not able to carry all these people alone.
A reading from the book of Numbers, Numbers chapter 11, verse 4 to 15. In those days, the people of Israel said, "Oh, that we had meat to eat. We remember the fish we ate in Egypt for nothing. The cucumbers, the melons, the leeks, the onions, and the garlic. But now our strength is dried up, and there is nothing at all but this manna to look at." Now the manna was like coriander seed, and its appearance like that of gum raisin. The people went about and gathered it, and ground it in mills, or beat it in mortars, and boiled it in pots, and made cakes of it. And the taste of it was like the taste of cakes baked with oil. When the dew fell upon the camp in the night, the manna fell with it. Moses heard the people weeping throughout their families, every man at the door of his tent, and the anger of the Lord blazed hotly. And Moses was displeased. Moses said to the Lord, "Why have you dealt ill with your servant? And why have I not found favor in your sight, that you lay the burden of all these people upon me? Did I conceive all these people? Did I bring them forth that you should say to me, 'Carry them in your bosom,' as a nurse carries the sucking child, to the land which you swore to give their fathers? Where am I to get meat to give to all these people? For they weep before me and say, 'Give us meat that we may eat.' I am not able to carry all these people alone. The burden is too heavy for me. If you will deal thus with me, kill me at once. If I find favor in your sight, that I may not see my wretchedness." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Fidelis Vetungura, celebrating his birthday today, a Daily Bread member from the Archdiocese of Mbarara, Uganda.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 14, verses 13 to 21. At that time, when Jesus heard of the death of John Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a lonely place apart. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. As he went ashore, he saw a great throng, and he had compassion on them and healed their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a lonely place, and the day is now over. Send the crowds away to go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They said to him, "We have only 5 loaves here and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowd to sit down on the grass, and taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke and gave the loaves to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And they all ate and were satisfied. And they took up 12 baskets full of the broken pieces left over. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What wonderful, beautiful, touching readings we have today, talking about the responsibility God has placed upon us. And our response should be that of patriotism, should be that of sense of belonging. Look at Moses. I love this passage and how Moses himself responded to the pleas of the people. He also grumbled to God. People grumbled to Moses, and Moses went to God. But I like this conversation that Moses had with God. He went and cried to God, and he said, "And why have I not found favor in your sight that you lay the burden of all these people upon me?" Everything was placed upon Moses. And Moses recognizes that these are the people of God. And he cried to God, "Did I conceive them? Did I bring them forth?" Like saying, "Listen, you conceived them. You brought them forth. You brought them into this world. Then why should you put everything on my head? Carry them in your bosom as a nurse carries the sucking child." Yeah, right. But did I bring them here? They are your creation. Moses recognizes, yes, the whole responsibility has been placed upon him to take care of the flock of God. But at the same time, Moses understands that he won't manage without God. He won't manage without God helping him. How I wish our leaders could learn from Moses here. Many of our leaders do not understand that God has placed the responsibility of taking care of the children of God, of taking care of the people they are serving, with patriotism, with a sense of belonging. These are my people. It is God who entrusted this to me, and I am going to bend my knees before him and ask him to take care of my needs. I have known presidents who, many may not know, go to shrines, bend their knees. They would spend a full day in prayer, begging on behalf of the nation. I have known great leaders in this world who depend totally on God for anything and everything they do. Because I tell you, with your own strength, you cannot manage. Moses recognized that. You are looking at your family. The family you have is not your own family. Even if you might have given birth to somebody, it is not your child. That is the child of God. And if you want to take care of those children well, you have to learn to entrust those children into the hands of God. He brought them in this world. He conceived them. He made them. Since he made them, he will guide you into how to take care of them. He will show you how you are going to feed them. Moses said to God, "For they weep before me and say, 'Give us meat that we may eat.' I'm not able to carry all these people alone. The burden is too heavy for me. If you will deal thus with me, kill me at once. If I find favor in your sight, that I may not see my wretchedness." He realizes this won't work if he does everything by himself. He needs God to take charge. He needs the hand of God to be at work in what he's experiencing. And so he cries to God. And so if you are a mother, if you are a dad, if you are parents, learn to bend your knees to cry to God to assist you, to take care of those children. Look at the feeding of the thousands that we hear in the gospel passage of today. These people recognize that the people are too many to be taken care of. They need to be fed, but the few pieces they have, the few loaves that are with them, will not manage to take care of these people. And then they come to Jesus asking for help. What shall we do in this situation? Jesus said, give them something to eat yourselves. Don't send them away. Take up the responsibility. Put it in your hands. Oh no, but how can we manage with what we have? Bring what you have. And I will show you that you are able to manage. If you bring what you have, if you bring your energy to me, if you bring your strength to me, if you bring all that you have to me in prayer, I am going to help you manage thousands. I'm going to help you manage millions. I'm going to help you take care of what you think is impossible. He just wants us to learn to hand over everything into his hands through prayer. And he will take care. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I'm desperate for. Your bed.